Welcome back to Capitol Tonight this Wednesday evening. I'm Erin Billups. Well, we've been waiting for weeks to hear proposals from the governor or the state legislature on how to cut the growing budget gap. Today, we got one new plan from Senate Republicans. In a press release, the minority conference detailed their proposal to cut roughly $3 billion from the state budget. In their plan, they suggest significant cuts to Medicaid funding, freezing all purchases of recreational lands, and would stop more than $2 billion in what they call wasteful spending by Democrats in the Assembly and Senate. They went on to adamantly state they would not support a tax increase in this bill. Joining us now to talk a little bit more about that, the Republican plan, is Senate Deputy Minority Leader Tom Libous. Thanks for joining me today.
You're welcome, Erin. Good to be here.
So your plan is out. There were budget meetings today between the governor's office and legislative financial staff. Are you guys really being included in these conversations? Are they taking your proposal seriously?
Well, we're including ourselves. That's why we came out with a plan. Senator Skelos, our leader, had come out with a number of proposals and shared those with the governor, I think, as recently as last week. We decided that we're going to come out with a plan. No one else has. We understand that we have to address this deficit, and our plan does that. So they should take our plan very seriously. I think the governor should look at it. He should consider most of it. And quite frankly, the Senate Democrats, who supposedly are running the Senate, have no plan and no proposal. And that's very disappointing.
Let's talk a little bit about what's in your proposal. I noticed that you guys did not touch education. Why is that?
Well, you know, the Senate Republican Conference has always felt that education is a very important part of what takes place in New York State, and certainly educating our children is primary, and we shouldn't go there unless we absolutely have to. Commitments were made to school districts. You want to keep those commitments. One of the things that we go after is about $2.2 billion in spending that the Senate Democrats actually put in the budget this past April. Additional spending over and above when, you know, taxes were raised, and it was really kind of disappointing. So we're suggesting that we begin the process by looking at that $2.2 billion in spending, and I think a lot of it can be eliminated, and you're going to be a long way to close that $3 billion deficit.
You guys also suggest another 10% cut to the agency spending, the non-personal budget. Is that on top of the cuts the governor announced last week, or in support
I think,
of?
I think actually, you know, we made some of those recommendations to the governor, but I believe that they're in concert with what he was talking about. Again, our proposal does come out to about $3 billion, so those cuts need to be made. Okay. And we are actually looking at a very solid plan here that I think, you know, we've got to look at what happened in April. The Democrats in the Assembly and the Senate spend too much, they tax too much. I mean, there's additional $8 billion in taxes in this budget. It's time to reduce spending. That's what our plan does, and it's legitimate, and it says, let's go after the $2.2 billion that the Democrats added. I mean, they added money to a budget that had a huge deficit in the first place. That's not right. We need to start there and looking at cutting.
You're criticizing Democrats for adding all this spending to the current budget that we're in right now, but they've only been in power in the governor's office for a couple of years, in the Senate just for the past year. These problems of spending have been the culture in Albany for decades, even when Republicans were in control
of
the Senate.
Erin, that's true, and they have to stop now. And that's why we have come out with a comprehensive plan that is going to close the budget deficit. We understand that the taxpayers of this state are fed up. They don't want to see a penny more in spending. They don't want a penny more in taxes. You know, we have to look to the future. And right now, the future is not looking real good under the Democrats' proposal. The Democrats' proposals continue to increase taxes. Increase spending, and the Republican conference is basically saying, enough of that. We have to reduce spending, and that's what our plan does.
Well, today the comptroller announced that the deficit could grow to as large as $4.1 billion. Do you think that'll be enough, on top of the governor's warnings, to light a fire under the legislature and get something done sooner rather than later?
Well, it certainly needs to light a fire under the Senate Democrats, and certainly the Democrats in the Assembly, they control the houses of the legislature. The Republican Senate has a very good plan. I think we are on the way to help reduce the deficit, to reduce spending. I know that the comptroller says the number is bigger. I think the number continues to grow because we've taxed people out of the state. The Democrats this year put additional taxes in the budget, and businesses are leaving. It's not a good thing. That's why we've got to reduce spending, and we've got to, you know, do something fairly quickly. And we have a plan. The Republican Senate has a good plan. We're the only ones that have come out with a plan, and we'd like to put it into place.
You propose about $3 billion in cuts in your plan released today. Mm-hmm. The comptroller saying it could grow to as much as $4.1 billion. Where's that extra money going to come from?
That's a good question. Let's start with the reductions in spending that the Republican Senate has proposed today. And then I think we have to continue to dig. The reason why the deficit continues to grow is because revenues are not coming into the state. And I keep repeating this, but what happened when the Democrats passed the budget, a budget that our conference, our Republican conference, voted against, that increased spending by billions of dollars and increased taxes, it continued to drive business out of the state. It continued to reduce the revenues that come in. And that's a problem that we have, and it's going to continue to happen. So right now, our focus is reducing spending, getting spending under control.
Now, the governor has said he does not want to increase more taxes and fees, but he has said everything is still on the table. Republicans say they don't want to see any more tax increases, but with a deficit growing to $4.1 billion, it seems like that might have to remain on the table. Well,
we have some other recommendations that we're going to come out with also in our conference. You know, I sat on a commission that the governor actually set up, and I was appointed to it, on asset maximization. You know, the state has a number of assets. We talked about public-private partnerships being done, you know, all over the country, in Canada and other countries, and that helps to save taxpayers money where the private sector comes in and helps to become a partner. We've always shied away from that. There's a great report that's out with great recommendations. Over 300 bridges in the state could be repaired. School districts could save money on construction. We've got to start thinking outside the box, and I think our conference is prepared to start looking at some of these suggestions and making recommendations. You know, Carl Krueger and the finance chairman and Sheldon Silver said, well, we're not going to look at any of those proposals. Shame on them. We need to look at the proposals. We need to be creative. We need to look at new ways of reducing the budget deficit. It can't be taxes. Taxes are not an option.
Now, the governor is offering his cuts, his proposal, finally tomorrow. Many say that he tried to initially push the burden onto the legislature, and they're suspecting, critics, you know, pundits are suspecting that he won't touch health care and education. What are you looking forward to hear from the governor tomorrow?
Well, you know, I'm anxious, and our conference is anxious, and I know I spoke with Senator Skelos last night, and we talked about, you know, what the governor might propose. We have our plan. We're going to take his plan. The Senate Democrats have not put out a plan. That's pretty disappointing. So we're going to look at what the governor proposes, and we're going to try to work with the governor to reduce spending and not raise taxes. That's what our conference goal is. I would love to see the Assembly Democrats to come out with a plan. I would love to see the Senate Democrats to come out with a plan. We haven't seen it. So right now, we're going to deal with what the governor gives us. We're going to work with the governor. We're going to take our plan and see what we can come up with. But raising taxes is not an option for our conference.
Well, actually, getting a deficit reduction plan passed in the Senate may be difficult, especially if Senator Hiram Monserrat, who's under trial right now, loses his seat, but that would also give you guys, Republicans, a seat at the negotiating table.
I think it would put us in a position where we could continue to sell our plan that reduces spending and rejects any new taxes and gets the state back on a solid footing. And I think that's where we need to go. If you talk to the people in the street, the taxpayers, the folks that we represent, and I think all too often many of my colleagues forget that they represent people back home. They get caught up in the Albany politics. We're here, and we've got to reduce the deficit. We've got to reduce spending, and we've got to make sure that we don't tax anymore. They're fed up with taxes, and that's what the Republican Conference's goal is. We'll work with the governor on it, and as soon as the Democrats and the Senate can give us a plan, we'll look at their plan too. But right now, it's just a blank sheet of paper.
Okay. Well, that's all the time we have tonight. I just wanted to ask you a quick question.
Sure.
We know that you were recently diagnosed with prostate cancer. We were just wondering, probably your viewers, constituents out there are wondering how you're doing right
now. I'm doing great, Aaron. I'm getting my treatment at Memorial Sloan Kettering in New York City and hope to have surgery sometime in December. And thank God everything's going good.
Well, we wish you the best.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Senate Deputy Minority Leader Tom Livis.
Thank you.